Our panel now joining the panel. Nupur Sharma is member of the National Executive of the Bharatiya Janata Yuva Morcha, and she's one of the young faces of the BJP. Jaivish Shergill is spokesperson, media panelist of the Congress Party. Clyde Crasto is NCP spokesperson. We'll get him on the screen in a minute. Kamal Farooqi is joining us. Siddharthnath Singh continues. Let's begin. Where is, you know, one way of looking at it, Jaivir, is that you have people in their 30s and 40s now who are taking number one positions in the BJP. You have, for example, Pankaja Munde. She openly says, yes, I am in the running for chief minister. Almost says that. You have Devendra Fadnavis. I think he's 44-year-old. He could 44. Very well be the chief minister.
At 27, he was the mayor of Nagpur.
At 27, mayor of Nagpur, 44, chief minister of Maharashtra potentially. Like, then you have Captain Abhimanyu. How old is he?
45.
Again, 45 years old, could be the next chief minister of
Haryana.
Right. And in your party, the only young leader of any consequence seems to be Rahul Gandhi. That's 44-year-old. But besides him, you have no substantial second line of leadership. You are not projecting any satraps at the state level. Your party refuses to change its tack. And you are going from loss to loss, stumbling from loss to loss, almost as if inviting defeat upon yourself. Mr. Shergill, what is your party going to do with a more resurgent and a younger BJP leadership that is being built under Modi and Amit Shah? What are you going to do? Are you going to watch and get thrashed again and again?
Two points I want to make. Number one, it's ironical you give me BJP's example as far as young leadership is concerned. To the contrary, if you see Congress's line of leadership, whether it's Sachin Pilot at young age being heading the PCC, Jyotiraditya Scindia, the youngest parliament member of parliament came from Congress, the young MP from Lakshadweep during the last elections. So we have a very strong lineup. But this election, Haryana and Maharashtra, have to the contrary proved that this was not election for Mr. Modi. It was rather an attempt to hijack his own party in this, both the states, and diminish the leadership or the identity of the state leaders in the party.
How does that bother you?
I am not saying. How does that bother you? I am just countering your point.
So your point is that Modi is trying to hijack his own party. I've got your point. Let's get quick responses. Modi is trying to hijack his own party and Nupur Sharma is in splits.
So we all.
Obviously, Arnab, I don't know what is wrong with him. They don't even have any leadership. The point is, what you started with is correct. There is a second generation of leadership which is being effectively being worked upon in the party ranks. And you can see it by the way of examples, very few examples you took, but there are so many more. Not only men, they are the youngest women parliamentarians, 26, 27-year-old women are parliamentarians from the BJP in the Lok Sabha today. So I don't know what Jaivir is looking at. And the point is that the people that he's naming, they're no longer in the parliament. So maybe barring Rahul Gandhi, maybe Jyotiraditya Scindia.
Nupur, I understand whatever Jaivir, Mr.
Modi does. Jaivir, if it's you, please allow me to complete. I heard you go on. I fail to understand why do we do this? Modi is authoritarian. Modi is a separate entity. Mr. Modi is from the BJP. He rose from the ranks. He is one of us. And the fact is, he doesn't have any family behind him. So I think we all should appreciate that and really appreciate, and you should appreciate that development is the plank which has really worked in the Lok Sabha elections and now in the state elections.
No, see, the serious point is this. Jaivir, you see, understand what happened. If people are repeat non-performers or habitual non-performers, then there has to be action, right? Because if you are given a choice of perform or perish, you must perform and not perish. And those who perish in result after result must be punished. Now, in your case, Jaivir, those who perish electorally in result after result are rewarded. You get the irony here. And there is no change. As far as generational shift is concerned, BJP moved out LK Advani, BJP moved out Murli Manohar Joshi. They are part of the Margdarshak committee. So there's a generational shift. Do you realize the dangers of being status quoist? In today's day and age.
Let me say.
No, do you realize the dangers?
What I want to say.
Or is the only... Do you realize the dangers?
I just want to get in. Just one more point.
No, the picture...
Do you realize the dangers?
One second, Nupur, let me...
No, one more point. High command submits resignation to the high command, which the high command rejects. That's the biggest joke.
I know Nupur...
You screaming in my ear is not going to help.
I know, Nupur, I know your anxiety to speak because this is one of
anxiety, we are winning, we are happy, not anxious. You should be the one who should be anxious.
Whatever Mr. Modi does or whatever his bluff is, you have to uncomplainingly swallow by hook, line and sinker. Number two, please, on this channel, you tell me which of your leaders shared any remotely space in this during the entire campaign. None.
No.
You had to...
No, that is not true.
Jevi, during your New York speech,
only if you informed, do you argue on this point.
Unrelated.
Jevi, 1 minute.
Was telecasted
a small young character like me went into Haryana. Please, what are you saying, Jevi? Please, hang on a minute. You're not reading the newspapers enough. Are you trying to tell me that our campaign was only the rallies by the Prime Minister? He's the most important person. Thank God that he came down because it actually drove off the point.
Insecurity and paranoia.
Insecurity, you are losing.
Swept away with a wave of insecurity and paranoia after the recent bipolar.
Who should be insecure, Javir?
He's paranoid.
You can't even claim the post of opposition in Lok Sabha.
The question goes to our panelists. Sometimes paranoia is good.
Get a grip.
One minute, please. Shergill, Mr. Shergill.
Why did he leave our borders at risk?
Mr. Shergill, you see, I'll tell you one thing. Mr. Shergill, just give me a minute. And that's it, Navika. Let's get Hartosh, Sankarshan, Sabha, everyone into the debate. And my point is, if you're going to lose like this, again and again and again. I mean, even Kumar Ketkar, you're very supportive of the Congress party, but is it not time for someone in the Congress to start getting paranoid? You know, they should be paranoid. What is happening to us?
I think that paranoia has spoken, I think.
No, but acceptance of defeat. Acceptance of defeat is a worrisome trend.
In fact, their paranoia has spoken. That's why they did not conduct rallies. They did not build a party. They did not organize.
No, that's a sense of self-reflect.
Talking of election. They did not even conduct the campaign after 16th.
You're saying they gave up.
After 16th May, they are clearly giving up.
They gave up.
That's what I'm saying. I have been saying that. And you call me Congress supporter, but I'm not saying
Congress supporter. I'm saying I have been saying this
on your channel so many times that Congress has given up the fight. Congress has lost the contact with people.
Congress has given up the fight.
Yeah, obviously. I mean, that is
Congress
require,
has given up the fight, or Gandhi's have given up the fight.
Reiteration. Congress has given up.
Congress has given up. Nirja Chaudhary.
Also Sonia and Rahul.
Sonia and Rahul have given up the fight.
Yeah.
And what is Mr. Chauhan, fall guy?
I didn't hear him saying that, actually.
I'm coming to you in Delhi. We'll get into this debate. Mr. Shergill, listen, please. You know, the Gandhis are not beyond criticism, please. Accept, please. You know, 1 second, yeah.
I think there's huge, the word you used is paranoia. There is paranoia also within the Congress party.
You think
if you talk
is?
To people privately, they're worried. It's their future at stake. They don't know which way to go. Yeah. As we said, you know, Sonia Gandhi's energy is not what it used to be. Rahul is not, come
interested.
Up to scratch. Priyanka is not going to come into politics as of now. Where does the party go? Who the leadership is going to be? But, you know, they're not able to get together and call a spade a spade. What's their way forward? You had the CWC after the defeat, and what did it add up to? It only tried to dissuade Rahul Gandhi and Sonia Gandhi from not going ahead with their resignation. That's all it amounted to. So somehow...
But don't you think the survival instincts of the other Congress leaders is now going to be at a high?
Well, they should be. They should be. Otherwise, the party, as you say, is... What is the future?
It's a widespread phenomenon.
No, one minute. I'm coming to Delhi in a minute here.
Have a point. High poll election result.
One second, Mr. Shergill. 1 minute. Listen to this.
In 1967, when Mrs. Indira Gandhi lost as many as 10 states, UP, Punjab, Tamil Nadu, Kerala, she decided to change the structure of the party.
So what is
that's how the party was split. I am not saying party should be split or not should be split. I am entirely agreeing with Arnab when he said that wouldn't there be a revolt in the party against the paranoia, against the conflicts?
You know, one thing
there has to be some kind of Kumar, rebellion.
Before you go to
think there will be.
It's building up.
There will
no,
be.
No, one second. Before we go to Delhi, one last point.
The rebellion was there in 67.
One last point before we go to Delhi. Everybody is talking about the fact that consumer is king and therefore the voter is king. Why are you not looking at the way the voter is going and stop thinking about what you think, yeah, whether Modi is great, Rahul is not, this is not. Yeah. What is the voter telling you?
Yeah.
Whether there's paranoia or not is irrelevant. You are losing. Finished. Yeah. Are you worried about the people who vote for you? Are you worried about your own leaders?
The question is, in a world where Pankaja Munde, Devendra Fadnavis, Captain Abhimanyu become the next generation leaders of the BJP, is anyone, let that I throw to our studios in Delhi. Is anyone
so
telling Ken Janpath?
Sachin Pilot, Jyoti Raditya Sindhya.
There is absolutely no reason why the Congress leaders like Sonia Gandhi and Rahul Gandhi are looking like at this entire issue as a challenge. For them, their life begins from their own cocoons and ends there, because they're not looking at the party. And
so,
what Neerja says is very
so
correct.
Sorry.
You meet
the
leaders of the Congress
the
party
Congress,
on any given
BJP,
day and they are talking about the crisis
person,
their party is in. Sonia Gandhi is not getting younger. Rahul Gandhi is not getting up to
party,
the mark. And then they're losing
the
election
Indian
after
Congress,
election. What's going to be the future of all of these young people?
A minute, please.
Sorry.
Arnab, I heard Jaiveer say that there's centralization of power in one person. Please ask Jaiveer what does he mean by that when he belongs to a party where the central leadership is increasingly failing. Again, the reposition of faith is in the same leadership. It's a vicious circle.
Jaiveer,
allow me to complete. Somebody spoke about the structure. What will the structure of the party do when there is no leadership and there is no vision trickling down to the structure?
Arnab, the crisis is so great in the Congress. Today I spoke to a very young, significant part of the Young Turks. I mean, they're talking about literally having to migrate to where their constituencies are. I'm not going to give names over here. It's very, I mean, no one has any faith left in Rahul Gandhi.
Okay, so my question to Kamal Farooqi. No, one second. Politics is never stagnant. What's up, Mr. Shergill? Kamal Farooqi and Clyde Crasto. Clyde Crasto and Kamal Farooqi.
Classify that as a...
Clyde Crasto and Kamal Farooqi are also on the debate. You see, politics is never going to be endlessly static. If there is one poll, there will have to be another poll. Right? If there is Mr. Modi, somebody will want to pose a challenge. Now tell me, Clyde, let me come to you first and then I'll go to Kamal Farooqi on this. Is everybody going to repose their faith on Rahul Gandhi as the challenger to Modi? Not just Congress to BJP, but at a national level? Or will this series of defeats force parties, even like the NCP, to think otherwise?
Well, when it comes to Rahul Gandhi, I think the Congress spokesperson can speak much more for him. But I also want to say, like, there's so many people talking at the same time. It's so difficult to decipher what the person is saying. So I think it's better that, just one person talks or maybe two people talk, but it's getting very difficult, And can you repeat your next,
My question is simply to you, Clyde. That do you believe that now with defeat after defeat behind the Congress party, that parties like the NCP will continue to rally with the Congress? Already there's been so much tension between both your parties. Right? What is going to be a long-term political gain?
We're already on our own,
Yeah, no, you are on your own, but at a national level, is the Congress party going to be in its own corner?
Yeah.
At a national level, Clyde, what happens at a national level?
That's for the Congress to answer. See,
But you've detached yourself from the
That's
Congress.
That's for the Congress to answer. That's for them to introspect.
No, but you've detached yourself from the Congress.
We are already alone. We are fighting the...
So do you believe...
We are, though. Okay, you can see that. We are already doing...
Do you believe, Clyde, that this result now is against the kind of crony capitalism which the NCP is fond of? The fact that you were putting pressure on Prithviraj Chauhan through the Congress Party central leadership not to act in the irrigation scam? And have you learnt your lessons on the issue of corruption and crony capitalism? Maybe you took the people of Maharashtra for granted.
See, Arnav, these are exit polls.
No. Was Prithviraj Chauhan lying when he said that? When Prithviraj Chauhan said that, you know, he was... That if he had taken action against Ajit Pawar that or against the NCP, that the government would have fallen. Were you holding the Congress Party to ransom? Were you holding Prithviraj Chauhan to ransom on a corruption issue?
Absolutely not. Absolutely not. You said something. Then the press also says that he's denied what he says. So I guess he knows best. But we've not pressurized anybody in RBI into all that.
So what are your lessons right now as you sink to the lowest? I just want to just think. What are the Congress and the NCP going to do? Both these parties sink to their lowest ever performance in Maharashtra. You can't sink lower than this. What are you going to do? Cling on to each other, break away, learn your lessons, or what?
See, these are exit polls. Let's get to the results. Let the results come out.
Okay.
And then we'll see what we
answer.
Have to do. So we'll introspect and then go accordingly.
Okay. Kamal Faruqi, throw that question to you at a national level. What do you think is going to happen now? Is the BJP going to remain unchallenged for a very long period of time with these kind of results behind them?
Yeah, Arnab, two quick comments on that. One, that defeat after defeat, Congress has not learned any lesson at all. So this is one thing. Whereas Modi has learned a lesson from the bipoles. In fact, they tried to use... They left aside the development plank and they went into the communal plank and they were totally disseminated in the bipoles, in fact. So Modi corrected the whole thing again and he went again to the development agenda. So there are two lessons. One for the Congress, that if they do not learn any lesson, they will be totally disseminated. They have to bridge their gap with Sharad Pawar or Mamta or any other friendly party. Whereas for Modi ji, it is very important to understand that the country needs the development plank. They don't want a hatred plank. They don't want a Hindutva plank. They don't want the communal divide. They want everyone. Everyone in the country wants that the country should develop and there should be a communal harmony. I'm happy that during this, both in Haryana and the Maharashtra, no communal face has found any place over there. But so all of them were kept aside.
But you think it's a permanent shift now. You think it's a permanent shift now. You think Modi takes over a more centrist, perhaps a little bit more open, less inclined towards religious polarization, that kind of BJP comes in. You know, you seem to think so. Does Sabha agree? Does Artosh agree? Does Navika agree on that? Is that going to be the way for things to come?
Okay.
A new BJP that moves away from the hardline elements of the Sangh Parivar and charts its own you know, path ahead. Sabha.
I wish that were true, but I just want to say one thing. The next election, significant state election, will be in Bihar, where there's no Congress. After that, we'll have Uttar Pradesh and Bengal. Again, no Congress really in any significant way. There'll be other people who'll be fighting the BJP. I think Mr. Modi and Amit, even during the Lok Sabha campaign, Mr. Modi did selectively raise issues like pink revolution and all in areas like Assam and Bengal. I think on a larger scale, he will not use it. But I am certain that if the occasion, he's been very pragmatic. This is a very pragmatic communalism. When you think it's going to bring you electoral rewards, you've used it. I'm sure Mr. Shah has been told that for now, no. I hope Mr. Modi evolves in that direction. But yes, but just the other day they were using that card and he never had a word of condemnation for Yogi Adityanath. You know, yeah.
But the miscalculation of the bipoles is something that the BJP has learned a lesson from. And as far as the BJP short run is concerned, the Bihar elections and the Jharkhand elections, where they go in next, they're clearly going to avoid any communal polarization and they're going to stick to the development agenda. And why not? It seems to be paying for them. If you have Modi as the face and development as the agenda, it seems to be working.
New BJP, younger regional satraps. All good, Congress party decimated, is that really the rosy picture?
Oh, I'm sorry. Arnab, may I say something? Congress,
you know, I've been listening to this for a long time on this program, and I'm frankly very baffled with this. Will Modi tear himself away from the RSS? This country has put into the Prime Minister's seat a prachara. Please understand that. He has civilizational differences with how this country has run for 60 years. He has those. Look, there'll be it is not just love jihad. It's the way
he took on the RSS. He's taken on the VHP. He's taken on the RSS in Gujarat.
Want to do that.
Come on, please.
Is Mr. Alag going to say here?
Yeah, just going to carry on the same point again and again.
No. Mr. Alag, are you saying that Mr. Modi is going to tear himself away from the organization?
Whenever the VHP or in Gujarat, he has.
Are you disowning the RSS?
He has taken on the RSS and the VHP in Gujarat.
Please.
Oh, come on. Yeah, he has. Let's stick to the facts.
Okay, look.
He has.
No, I think one minute.
A man who thinks very differently has come to power.
Please allow me to speak.
I'm not saying this combatively. I'm just saying we need to understand a man who thinks very differently has now come to be India's Prime Minister, and the consequences will follow.
Nupur Sharma, yes, rebutting you. 3 minutes left this debate.
One RSS gives us ideological support and also back in support as long as
grounding
it's an NGO. Please allow me to complete.
The examples are
you ended. Don't start, sir. Your own netas were blamed in the Muzaffarnagar riots first. Please stop.
We did not crown them.
Oh, please.
You had a special function.
Allow
to
me
them.
To.
Can
I come back to the point? Two, I think Mr. Modi made it amply clear before he went into Lok Sabha elections that he will run the country according to the Constitution of India.
Yeah.
Please tell me if going on the development plan, I don't know what problem Jay has. Please tell me if going on the development plan is a problem. And please tell me anybody who's satisfied with the way the country has been running for the seventh decade now, into the seventh decade now, and still calling us young, that's why we are not developed. That's a lame excuse. I don't know what Javed is talking about. Javed, either you allow me to speak or you wait for me to finish and then speak, please.
Let him speak, please. You know, you could don't run him over just because you're on a winning streak.
No, there is no question of that.
But that's what's happening. Voters are doing it to them.
Javed is clutching at straws, you know, like, I mean, it's not right.
Let him speak.
Force feed RSS ideology through national TV, number one. Number two, did you not crown your MLAs involved in riots? Number three, did you not set a new example by force feeding yourself on Teachers Day?
You know what? We can start a blame game by me asking you what have you done about 1984?
Don't even have chalk and blackboard.
Now, you see,
did you not give a gift of love jihad instead of development?
We finished that.
Javed,
you're living in the past. We finished with that already.
Exactly. What are you going to do? If you were so good, why are you not winning?
Ms. Parulekar,
please answer me these four things.
Mr. Shergill, that will take a longer time. Ms. Parulekar, we are hearing here that the possibility that the Shiv Sena may still be invited in a sort of a large magnanimous gesture, the BJP may say, come on, be with us, keep the alliance going, junior partner. Will you accept that? After all, Anand Gite is still in the cabinet.
See, it is for our party president Uddhavji to decide what will be right at that moment.
Open to it.
We've always been their partners for the last...
Swallow a lot of pride for that.
It just depends what Uddhavji will decide to do.
Mr. Modi said he never spoke a word against Shiv Sena because of his respect for Baba. No, I mean, he's left the door open. Yeah. Everybody's left the door open. So what's the question?
Okay. The longer term impact, you know, after this, Jay and Nirja, I'd like to come to you on this. Longer term impact you're going to think of this in the coming state elections and national elections.
If the BJP succeeds, it's trying to go ahead and replicate this Ekla Chalo plan in Bengal, Odisha. Mm. Tamil Nadu, they might try and rope in Rajnikant. The game plan should be, ideally for them, in 2019, we get another majority on our own. Because right now, they've peaked in the states from where they've got the seats.
Yeah.
So they need to develop an alternate catchment area, and that's what they would develop.
So the whole BJP game has been since May, keep building the momentum. Through perception building events like Madison Square, through elections, through speeches, through campaigns.
Ravi Shankar Prasad made a very important point. He said, the art of communication in this new politics is what the Congress is missing. And I think the BJP is
so. You see.
Art of communication that Modi has developed is not necessarily the art of communication that will always succeed.
Absolutely.
There is something yeah. called a fatigue point.
There, could no, be
there is something called overkill. I think what he has done, he has done the overkill campaign, and that campaign might succeed for a while. Yeah. For but a while. we are talking at least of next 5 years,
Absolutely.
4.5 years.
Congress
and Congress has no communication plan, communication strategy.
You think
fine, but the point is, this does not mean that this is the same strategy, okay. continuous sloganeering, and all that yeah. will bring them
Nirja.
Between 2019. Yeah. I don't think that will work.
Nirja.
While I agree with him that BJP will go on the Ekla Chalo path now, having tasted blood, the other side, which is the non, now it's the BJP versus the rest. That rest will be forced to come together in
right.
alliances at the state level, maybe national level. But if the BJP was smart, they would invite the Shiv Sena, even though they don't need them, invite
yeah.
the INLD. Right. So these parties who were allies won't go to the opposition side.
So you build the real super NDA,
yeah.
but a super NDA no, that is centered around the BJP that
qualify,
does not necessarily
to qualify
need
what Nirja says.
As
you leave the opposition
policy.
Space to a weak Congress rather than letting a Sena sit in the opposition.
That's very interesting. Well, I thank you. I thank you all very much.
Okay.
Sabha wanted to say something. Sabha, wrapping up. Yes, you wanted to quickly make a point. Yes, Sabha. And, yeah.
No. I believe that the changes that we are seeing in this, you know, as the Congress was the single party which ruled for years and years, I think we are entering a phase where this is one step ahead
and
of the BJP becoming exactly
that. Amit Shah becomes
so,
very
yes.
strong as well. That's, you know,
no,
one thing which
Amit
Shah becomes a very, very strong, you know, second pole in the BJP almost.
Arnab, there's one thing I want to differ on, please. That I don't think we are in an elongated election mode period. There was a lull also because these state elections are happening 4 months after the
right.
central elections.
But Modi's campaigns
and I think there's
have
nothing wrong
like
with the Prime Minister.
But Modi's campaigns have been as if he's in permanently election mode.
But
whether
not
it's
not an
when you are getting into election, you have to be in
election
mode. I think you can't just say
last word go to Kamal Farooqi. Self-centered election mode.
I mean, you have to be in election mode when elections are announced.
Even
you can't be
on
the stage
all the time.
Kamal Farooqi.
Arnab,
whatever.
Kamal Farooqi.
Arnab, while wishing Mr. Modi all the best. I feel very sorry about Congress. They are still trying to not on the same plank. In fact, they are still not correcting themselves. There
right.
are no correction in Congress.
Absolutely.
I feel sorry for them. In
but
fact,
but course correction can't be done
for,
by somebody else. I thank you all very much for that
the
very interesting chat on the news hour tonight.
Jaivir is still speaking.